In today's video, I'll show you my dog's favorite way to exercise. It's kind of like if we had a rabbit that would run around our yard for the dog to chase. Only in this case, the rabbit is actually just a plastic bag tied to a line of string running all the way around our lawn. Dog fanatics call this sport lure coursing. It's a great outlet for all the energy of an active dog. And today I'll show you the easiest way to accomplish this in your own backyard using a fun product called Swift Paws. We have the perfect backyard for Swift Paws. We live on a half-acre lot with a gigantic lawn here in our backyard. Not so great looking this time of the year because I'm shooting this in February and everything's kind of dormant back here right now, but we're going to have fun with Swift Paws today here in the yard. Now, we had this house custom built for us about a year and a half ago, and we knew at that point that after we moved in, we'd be getting a new puppy. And I know that a tired puppy is the best behaved puppy at all, so I'm always looking for ways to tire out Carly, our new Cocker Spaniel puppy, and Swift Paws is one of the greatest ways I've found to do that. From a very early age, Carly showed an interest in chasing toys and retrieving them. This was one of our earliest attempts at coming up with a system for her to chase things and burn off energy in our yard. And eventually we found Swift Paws on the internet, and we've been having so much fun with it ever since it arrived. Now let me show you how to set up Swift Paws here in the yard. I like to start by placing three of the pulleys in three corners of the lawn. There's a little rope attached to the back of the pulley. Use one of these metal stakes to secure the pulley in the corner of the lawn. Then do the same thing with another pulley in another corner of the lawn. And the same thing again with a third pulley in the third corner of the lawn. Then in the fourth corner of the lawn, I'm going to place the heart of the Swift Paws system, a battery-powered motorized pulley. This is what's going to power the entire system. Now we're going to lay out the string. What I like to do to get started is to make a little loop at the end of the string line. Then I just take that loop at the end of the string and temporarily attach it to the stake behind the motorized unit. From there, it's just a matter of laying a line of string all the way around the perimeter of the lawn from one pulley to the next. And each time you get the string to one of the pulleys, you just pop open the lid of the pulley, feed the string around it, and then put the lid back down. Then just keep unwinding the string and head down to the next pulley. It's the same process each time you get to a pulley. Pop the lid, feed the string around the pulley, close the lid. Now we're on our way to the third pulley. Just keep laying down that line of string. At the third pulley, same thing. Pop the lid, feed the string around, close the lid. By the way, notice that knot in the string. That's just a place where the string broke during a previous session. If that happens, just tie it back together. A knot in the line won't hurt anything. And now here at the fourth corner of the lawn, this is where the motorized pulley goes. Remember that loop I put at the beginning of the string? I'm just going to use a little Boy Scout knot to tie the other end of the string to the loop, making one big continuous run of string going all around the lawn. Now we have to make a very important tension adjustment. We're going to position this motorized pulley far enough back that the loop of string is tight, but not too tight. You're not going to get this right the first time you try it, but with a little trial and error, you'll learn just how far back to go to get the tension just right. Now we just need to attach our lure to the line. The lure is just basically a plastic bag with no bottom, and I'm going to attach it to a little bit of string that was left dangling when I made that loop at the very beginning of the line. Another Boy Scout knot, and the bag is firmly attached to the line. And that's our lure right there. That's what the dog will chase like it's a rabbit. The very last step of the setup process is just to open the battery compartment on the motorized unit, attach the battery, and then put the battery cover back on. Now you can turn on the switch on the back of the motorized unit, Press the power button on the remote control, and this system is operational. The remote control is quite comfortable to hold. That white thing by the tip of my thumb is how you control the direction and speed of the system. The speed is adjustable, just using your thumb. Push that white thing down to get everything going one direction. Push it up if you want to go in the opposite direction. And the further up or down you move it, the faster everything goes. Carly has been very patient with me while I've been setting this up. It's time to let her run. Here's a montage of Carly in action with Swift Paws. Give some really important advice to anyone who might be thinking about buying Swift Paws. It's important to understand the three different versions of Swift Paws that you have to choose from. The most expensive version of Swift Paws actually costs several thousand dollars, but that's not for people like you and me. It's a professional model meant for use at competitive lure coursing events where the system needs to run for hours as various different dogs compete. Now, people like you and me aren't going to spend thousands of dollars on something like Swift Paws, and that's why Swift Paws makes two different systems for home use. I want you to pay close attention now to the differences between these two Swift Paws systems for home use. The lowest price home system is the original version of Swift Paws. They just call this one Home Original. It's a less powerful system that runs on a much smaller battery than the system I've been showing you in this video so far. What I've been showing you here in my backyard is the better, more expensive version of Swift Paws for home use. It's known as Home Plus. And this is the one I very strongly recommend because it has a much larger, much more powerful battery than the Home Original system has. On the left is the powered pulley unit for the Home Original system, and on the right is the powered pulley unit for the Home Plus system. It's really easy to tell the two units apart because the battery on the Home Plus system is so much larger than the one on the Home Original system that they had to design this much bigger cover for the battery compartment in order to accommodate it. If you look at the specifications written right on the two batteries, it's easy to understand the difference. The little battery that comes with Home Original has only a 1550 milliamp hour capacity. But the big battery that comes with Home Plus has a capacity more than three times larger, 5000 milliamp hours. The reason that this is important is runtime. That little battery that powers the home original system runs out of power quickly. After only about 10 to 15 minutes of use, you have to stop using home original and wait about 2 to 3 hours for the battery to have time to recharge. That is a major frustration when using home original. The battery just dies way too soon. My strong advice to you is to get Home Plus, just because of the much larger battery. You will literally be able to play for 3 times as long before needing to recharge the battery. And because the charger that comes with Home Plus is also more powerful, charging the battery on Home Plus happens about an hour faster than charging Home Original. The bigger battery that comes with Home Plus also makes it possible for the whole system to run faster. While Home Original can only get the lure moving at up to 30 miles per hour, Home Plus is able to run at up to 36 miles per hour thanks to that big battery. Another big difference between the two systems is the number of pulleys that are included. Home Original comes with 3 pulleys plus the motorized unit. Home Plus actually comes with 5 pulleys plus the motorized unit. And that allows you to be even more creative with how you lay out your lure course. I've used both systems, Home Original and Home Plus, and my strong recommendation to you is to spend the extra money to get Home Plus. The larger battery and more powerful charger are worth all the money, and the 2 additional pulleys are a nice added bonus. Carly and I have a lot of fun here in our backyard playing with Swift Paws. She absolutely loves it, and it's such a good way to burn off some of that energy she has. Carly takes much longer naps now that we've found this great way for her to be active. You can buy Swift Paws directly from their website at www.swiftpaws.com, and their customer service is fantastic. I've had Cockers ever since I was about 10 years old. It's a very energetic breed, and this is the best way I've found to burn off some of that energy. I'm Jim Zim. Thanks for watching.